Hello, today we'll deal with diabetic medications that can affect the weight of the patients. And we will divide antidiabetic medications into three main groups. The first group are antidiabetic medications that can cause weight loss. And this is something positive for all diabetic patients, since most of diabetes type 2 patients are actually obese. And I will list the medications now in decreasing order of glycemic efficacy. This means that the medications that I'm saying the first now are having the best glycemic efficacy, meaning they are the most efficient in decreasing glucose in the blood. So, the first group of medications can cause weight loss, as we said, and these are GLP-1 agonists, Pramlintide, and SGLT2 inhibitors. The second group are those that are weight neutral, namely Metformin, DPP-4 inhibitors, and alpha-glucosidase inhibitors. Then we have the third group, and these are those that can cause actually weight gain. And these are Insulin, Sulfonylurea, Glinides, and Thiazolidinediones. And we can say that the first group has a very big advantage. So GLP-1 agonists, Pramlintide, and SGLT2 inhibitors all can cause weight loss. And this means that out of the first group, the GLP-1 agonist has the highest glycemic efficacy and also causes weight loss. And this does not mean that GLP-1 agonist has the highest glycemic efficacy from all of the diabetic medications. The actual antidiabetic medication that has the highest glycemic efficacy is actually insulin. So let us look at the antidiabetic medications now in decreasing order of glycemic efficacy. So we have insulin, as we said, metformin, sulfonylurea, GLP-1 agonists, glinides, thiazolidinediones, pramlintide, DPP-4 inhibitors, alpha-glucosidase inhibitors, and SGLT2 inhibitors last. Out of this list, we can see that the medications causing weight loss are GLP-1 agonists having the fourth highest glycemic efficacy, with Pramlintide being in the middle, and SGLT2 inhibitors actually having the lowest glycemic efficacy. So in one hand, SGLT2 inhibitors are very good since they cause weight loss, but on the other hand, they have a very low glycemic efficacy compared to the other medications. So GLP-1 agonists cause weight loss, as we said, and also has a very high glycemic efficacy. What about the best glycemic efficacy medication now? What is it called? Insulin. Insulin causes weight gain, which is a disadvantage. Then we have metformin on the other hand, which has the second highest glycemic efficacy, and it actually is weight neutral, as we said. And therefore, one can say that metformin is the best medication since it has a very high glycemic efficacy together with no change in the weight of the patient. What about the other two medications that are weight neutral, namely DPP-4 inhibitors and alpha-glucosidase inhibitors? These have also fairly low glycemic efficacy. One can say that GLP-1 agonist and metformin are the best choice when choosing antidiabetic medications, since they both have a very high glycemic efficacy and are also weight neutral or weight loss medications. So, this does not mean that medications causing weight gain cannot be used. In fact, this group of medication has one of the highest glycemic efficacy, as we have seen. Insulin has the highest, sulfonylurea is in the third place, glinides are in the fifth place, thiazolidinediones in the sixth place. So let us refresh our memory now. The antidiabetic medications with the highest glycemic efficacy listed in decreasing order are insulin, metformin, sulfonylurea, GLP-1 agonists, glinides, thiazolidinediones, pramlintide, DPP-4 inhibitors, alpha-glucosidase inhibitors, and SGLT2 inhibitors. Now let's regroup them into these three groups. The first group that are weight loss medications are GLP-1 agonists, SGLT2 inhibitors, and Pramlintide. Second group that are weight neutral are metformin, DPP-4 inhibitors, and alpha-glucosidase inhibitors. Then we have the third group. These are weight gain medications, insulin, sulfonylurea, thiazolidinediones, and glinides. I thank you very much for listening and take care. Bye-bye.